Hello. What we have here is a gateway laptop. It's an NV series. It is a 55S24U. It has a quad core AMD processor. It's an A6 3400M. AMD Radeon on the graphics. It's got a 4 gigs of DDR3 RAM. 640 gig hard drive. It's a 15.6 inch display. As you can see, I've already taken it out of the box. I've set this laptop up for people. It gives the owner's manual, power cord. One thing about this is one of the laptops that if you want to recovery CDs for your computer, you must burn those yourself. Now, also in the packaging, they have this nice felt liner that they put over the laptop. I thought that was just nice. Keeps it, any of the dirt, dust, scratches, stuff like that off. Now, this laptop actually feels fairly sturdy compared to a lot of the laptops out there. You notice the collar of the laptop is white. That is part of in the decision making of buying this laptop, because the person wanted a white laptop, and this is one of the better deals we found at the time on a white laptop. Now, it's a gateway, running Windows 7, of course. I did some Skype calling with this particular laptop, and it does have a built-in web camera and a mic. The speakers are very adequate for, you know, your normal computing. It's not going to give you concert sound like music, but overall the Skype experience went well. Now the video camera is not like a Logitech C910 or nothing like that, but it's very capable webcam. It gives you a nice clear picture. If you're doing fast movements or something like that, you'll get a little stutter, but it's fairly decent. I mean, as far as webcams go, it's very usable for Skype calling, Google Hangouts. Now, the Windows experience on this laptop rates it at a 5.2. This is something I kind of sort of noticed right off. The speaker grill is also incorporated in one piece and goes around all the keys. So this is a one piece overlay that if you ever had to do the keyboard, you'd have to take that off, but that's really not a problem. Now, another deciding factor on this laptop was it has an HDMI out port, which that means with HDMI out, you can connect a single wire to your television and you can have sound and picture in a single wire. Now, something else I do like about this laptop is that it has a speaker mute button, lower the volume, and a raise the volume button. One button, okay? One for high, one for lower, and one for mute. There's no pressing the FN key to have to do that. So if you're somewhere, you can reach over and do a one button volume control. I like that feature. Now, one feature I don't like is tap to click. I like to turn tap to click off. I don't want tap to click. This laptop, I took a look, and I didn't see the feature to turn this off made readily available to me. I didn't dig real hard into the settings to see or research it or nothing, but I like when they have tap to click where you can turn it on and off easily, you know, just by a couple clicks of the mouse. Now this computer, another thing about this computer, I'm going to edit you while I pass the password in. Another thing about this computer that I did not like is that the fan seems to be a touch loud on it, the cooling fan, which I guess most people probably wouldn't even notice it, but I just see enough laptops and stuff like that that it's just a little noticeably a little more louder than some. Boot up time is fairly decent on this. The screen display is fairly good, which you probably can't see too good here. I like putting the CPU and RAM meters on. That's a Windows 7 feature I like. If your computer seems to be a little slow or something, you can at the time look up and see if there's a process running or something very easily. Now this has a multi-gesture touchpad, which they have a little demonstration here, and they're showing a guy, he has his thumb here and pulling his finger away, so you can do more than one movement at a time and get a reaction out of the key or the touchpad. I've not really played with that feature enough to be real familiar with that, so I really can't tell you whether I like that or not, but it is there. Overall, the laptop seems to be fairly sturdy, fairly well built. I haven't tried battery life to see how many hours it'll go on battery. I was just setting it up for them, so I, you know, didn't want to. But overall, I would rate this laptop as a very decent laptop for the average computer user. Now, I say my really only gripe is that the fan is a touch loud, but I mean it's probably something that most people wouldn't even notice. But that's my review of the laptop.